Around 6:30 a.m. this morning, our 911 dispatchers received a call for multiple shots being fired at ABB Incorporated at 4350 Simple. The company has a business with about 40 to 50 employees located inside. There was an active shooter inside the business armed with an assault rifle and a handgun. Dozens of officers responded initially, along with our tactical team. When they entered the building, they immediately found one victim, a white male we believe to be the shooter. He was pronounced deceased on the scene. We do not have the name of the suspect right now. We believe it to be the suspect who has committed these crimes inside the building, but we haven't made a complete identification at this point in time, but we're very confident that this is the shooter. Once inside, we had to do a massive sweep of the building. There are a total of 8 victims. 5 were transported to the hospital. 3 are in critical condition. We also found that there were actually 3 victims deceased on the scene, not including the shooter. As you can imagine, we're in the process of notifying first of kin of the victim's injuries and also the deceased. Just to give you an idea of the size of the structure, it was about 200,000 square feet. We still have tactical teams that are inside the building attempting to clear the location. We are working with ABB, the employees, and also the managers of the company to sift through the events that happened today. We are working with them and also with other federal agencies. I'd like to say thanks to those who responded. This was certainly a team effort. The Highway Patrol had their tactical unit here. The FBI is here. St. Louis County assisted in this effort to secure the scene and make sure the victims were safe and transported to the hospital. We continue this investigation. We still have officers on the scene. We're still in the process of clearing the building. It will take a long time for us to put together the pieces of what happened today, but we're confident that we have the identity of the shooter, and we believe that we have no more victims inside the building. At this point in time, I'd like to turn it over to...
Before you leave, can we ask a question? Did you see when you first got in, you found the shooter?
Yes.
So you found him immediately when you entered the building?
We did, but we weren't clear that that was the shooter. So I'd like to turn it over to Chief Dennis Jinkerson to tell the perspective of the fire department.
Good afternoon. Fire department units arrived on the scene at approximately 6:45 this morning for a call of a shooter. We responded with a deputy chief from the EMS side and an ambulance who immediately called for additional assistance. So from that point, it progressed to a larger situation. At one point in time, we had 10 ambulances on the scene, each with 3 paramedics on board each unit, waiting for the police department to update the situation. So,
of the victims that were they were obviously shot, all the ones you transported, multiple shots. Can you describe any of the injuries?
At this time, I can't really comment on that. We transported 5 individuals, 3 critical.
Do they seem to be close shots or distance shots?
I'm not sure.
Can you tell us where you located the victims in the building?
I can't comment on that right now.
Chief, any idea at this point what may have been behind this shooting?
No.
No,
that's St. Louis Fire Department's job was to get on the scene and take care of the people who were shot and the victims and transport them to the hospital.
As I said before, it's still an active investigation. There were many employees on the scene there. We're working with the managers and representatives of ABB to piece together the puzzles of what happened today, and certainly we'll be doing quite a few interviews. And the investigation will be continuing, but we are not really sure what was the motive for today's shooting.
Was there any shooting outside the building before he got inside? Were any shots exchanged with another employee?
Yes, there were victims on the parking lot before we went into the building. So we had victims on the parking lot and also inside the building.
Did any of those victims exchange shots with the shooter?
We'd heard we're not positive right now. We've heard reports of that, but we're not sure.
Do you know if, in fact, the shooter died of a self-inflicted gunshot wound or not?
Well, it will take our investigation to determine that. We're pretty confident that the shooter is deceased, but it will take a lot more investigation to determine how those wounds were inflicted upon them.
No officer shot him?
No officers were shot, all officers. And I will take this time to say that, as I said, this was a team effort. The police department's officers who responded did an incredible job. We really worked well to get the building cleared, get the victims out who were injured, and to secure the area. And we really believe that the initial response of the officers probably ensured that there weren't more victims who were hurt.
How far did he get inside the building?
We're not confident right now as to how far he went inside the building. It's a very large complex, but it appears that we got there fairly quickly. So with a 200,000 square foot building, certainly he wasn't able to get too far into the building.
Was there an opportunity that he was perhaps targeting people inside this building, that he knew who these folks were? Was he targeting people?
We're not sure at this time. It'll take further investigation to find out.
How many victims outside as compared to inside? How many did he shoot outside before going inside?
We're not clear right now. We believe it was three victims outside the building.
Were those fatalities?
We believe the ones who were deceased were outside the building. I think it was the shooter was inside the building, and then one more who was deceased inside the building, and we believe it was two who were deceased outside the building. We're not really sure as to the victims who were not deceased, whether they were shot outside on the parking lot and ran in, or whether they were all inside the building. So it remains to be seen where everyone was located when the shooting occurred.
And are those five going to hospitals?
Is this entire project complex a crime scene at this point?
Absolutely.
And how long will it stay that way? When can this factory reopen?
It will stay closed until we continue complete our investigation.
It's a big, big place.
It's a huge place. Yes. So we will be there until we're confident that we've investigated every inch of that complex.
Are the five that went to the hospital?
Have you left something behind there?
Well, that's why we're still there. We still have tactical units inside. We will have canines sweep the entire complex. So we're going to do our best job to search every inch of that place as possible. Certainly, we want to make sure that all the weapons are cleared from the location, and we want to collect any evidence that help us piece together what happened today.
Could he have left the device behind?
We're not sure, but we are certainly clearing the entire location.
You went to the suspect's house. You found nothing. The house indicated anything that was going down, any letters or notes of that nature?
No, not at this time.
And no family members or anyone else hurt to your knowledge anywhere else?
Well, we're still in the process of investigating this, and we really don't want to disclose that information.
Do you not have all the relatives located?
No, we don't have all relatives located.
So you don't know what condition they might be in? You don't know if they're safe or not, is that correct, or you just can't locate them yet?
Well, you mean the...
I mean, you're not worried about their safety, or are
no,
you?
We're not worried about their safety at this point in time. But as I said, it's an active investigation. We're still piecing together puzzles, so there's a lot right now we don't know.
Chief, were the guns registered?
We don't know that.
How many weapons were recovered?
At this point in time, I only know of three weapons recovered.
And what were they?
No, I'm not sure.
What weapons were recovered?
We know of an assault rifle, a shotgun, and a handgun.
AK-47 is the first one. You know how many shots were fired?
We don't know.
Is it true that he had extra ammunition on him?
We don't know at this time.
And again, no officers fired any shot?
No.
I'm sorry, an assault rifle, a handgun, and what else?
Chief, he's tied all three of those guns?
That's Chief Dan Isom of the St. Louis Police Department. We're here at the North Patrol Division headquarters right now, serving the 6th, 7th, and 8th District. Again, he's verifying for us that this morning at about 6:30, police got their first 911 call to the ABB Incorporated, a transformer plant having about 40 to 50 employees, of shots being fired. Now, you heard the chief say the shooting started in the parking lot, and two fatalities in the parking lot, including the gunman, suspected gunman, and one fatality inside. Let me correct that. He might have said the gunman was inside because there's been confusion about that. There had been initial reports, some reports, that there may be some one of the employees had returned fire at the gunman at some point outside. That has not been verified by the chief. He did insist that no officer fired any shot, and they believed that the suspect killed himself. They also had five others wounded. They were taken to the hospital, three in critical condition, two in fair condition, last report. At this time, the investigation is still underway. Now, the chief is not identifying by name the suspect, but earlier today, they were issuing an alert and looking for 51-year-old Timothy Hendron of Webster Groves. 51-year-old Timothy Hendron of Webster Groves. They have been to his house. We had heard earlier, although the chief wouldn't confirm that now, and found nothing and nothing relating to what might have taken place or any threats. We do know that he had filed a lawsuit against his company over an issue, and that supposedly that lawsuit had started underway in Kansas City this very week. We'll continue to follow and update this story, but again, the last report from the chief right now, the shooter apparently died of a self-inflicted gunshot wound. No police officer fired any shot, and a total of 8 others were shot by the gunman. 3 of those dead, 5 wounded, other 5 wounded, 3 in critical condition, 2 in fair. We'll continue to update this story and, of course, have the very latest with more interviews, more details for you on News 4 at 5 o'clock and, of course, on KMOV.com.